In May, less than 3 months after the trip to China, President and Mrs. Nixon fly to Austria. They are greeted by Chancellor Kreisky and the citizens of Salzburg. Austria, in the heartland of Central Europe, has maintained its political neutrality since World War II, a constructive neutrality that has contributed to the easing of East-West tensions. The president's visit here begins a four-nation round of high-level discussions. At Schloss Klesheim Palace, Mr. Nixon and Dr. Henry Kissinger consult with Chancellor Kreisky on European problems and the role of smaller nations in an era of great power diplomacy. A luncheon is given in the president's honor before his departure. After a brief and informal stay, the president expresses his appreciation for the opportunity to learn Austria's thinking on the problems of Europe and the world. Moscow. A summit conference between the United States and the Soviet Union has been in preparation for many long months. President Nixon is met by President Podgorny, Premier Kosygin, and Foreign Minister Gromyko. This is the prelude to 8 days of hard-working meetings and negotiations. Sessions will take place in the halls and palaces of the Kremlin, 15th-century walled citadel of the Tsars. Catherine Hall is the site of the first full meeting of the Soviet and American delegations. At the in-tourist hotel, several hundred members of the international press have gathered to report on the progress of the talks. As they go about their daily lives, the citizens of Moscow and the world await news of the meetings. 5 major agreements are signed in the first 4 days. An environmental protection agreement to curb air and water pollution and help protect the Earth's resources on an international scale. An agreement on medical science and public health to develop programs and exchange information on widespread health problems, in particular cancer and heart disease. Agreement for cooperation in space to resolve problems of international law in the exploration of outer space and develop a joint U.S.-Soviet manned spaceflight in 1975. In science and technology, the two nations will work together on a broad range of problems that affect mankind. An agreement on the prevention of incidents at sea to improve communication between ships and reduce the danger of collisions. A trade commission is also formed to promote commercial relations between the countries. Through the days, Mrs. Nixon represents her country to the people of Moscow. Mrs. Nixon visits the world-famous Moscow Circus. Mrs. Nixon is taken on a tour of Moscow State University, the tallest structure in the city. There are 34,000 students at the university from 105 countries. The First Lady, Mrs. Brezhnev, and Mrs. Gromyko are honored guests at the Bolshoi Theater School, where they observe young dancers at work. Training begins early here at about the age of 7. That evening, the President and Mrs. Nixon, Mrs. Brezhnev, and Soviet leaders attend the Bolshoi Ballet for a special performance of Swan Lake.